Warning, this video may contain content that may not be suitable for children or anyone else that is easily offended. Strong language, graphic content, nudity, bad jokes, and a possible idiot, aka myself, may be featured in the following clip. Viewer discretion is advised, and is not responsible for any damages that you receive watching this video. Hey, sup y'all, it's Zims, and welcome to another reaction video. I already recorded a reaction video earlier, but the video I recorded won't be done until a few days later. But we're gonna be reacting to the Weasel's One Punch, what really happened, Jake Paul versus Tyrone Woodley to fight. If you guys are new to the channel, my name is Proud Zims, and welcome to the Crow's Nest. If you're not ready to be shooting, super down to the block, click on the link and watch the video in entirety, because I'm gonna be pausing and stopping and talking to the whole thing. This fight right here, man, I don't really talk too much about boxing or fight or anything like that, because most of the time, most days, these fights are not even what they say they are. It's a lot of stuff that goes into it, like money. Money rules everything, and that's just my basic opinion about everything, especially if it's like something I just cannot believe. Is it something, some things possible, upsets possible? Absolutely, but I don't know. It was just something about this fight to me that just didn't sit right with me, but we'll get into it as the video goes. But for now, let's get it.
Punch. Jake Paul KOs Tyrone Woodley out cold, worse than I've ever seen in MMA or boxing. Woodley has never been finished like that before. One single punch puts him on the canvas, and he was out for like a minute. And if you also notice the punch that Jake hit him with, there was more power that could have been generated in that. Jake Paul's proved time after time that he hits extremely hard. But the way the punch landed on Woodley, he actually lands with the back two knuckles. He landed with the pinky and the ring knuckle, which takes off power from the punch and makes it a lot easier for you to break your hand. Where you really want to hit is with the front two knuckles, because those are aligned with your arm. Your arm is aligned with the first two knuckles, meaning when you land with those, the full impact of your entire arm is drilling through. Notice how Jake's fist rotates after he hits Woodley. The back two knuckles are bouncing off Woodley's head and still had enough power to KO him like this. So Jake Paul cemented. The guy has legit knockout power. He can knock out anybody in the world at his weight class with one single punch.
Let's stop the cap, bro, in his weight class. Yeah, possibly, yes, but you have to understand, this dude fought a YouTuber. He fought, was it Ben Askren? Ben Askren was smiling after his fight. He got paid off 100%. Then he fought some other dude named Asim Gibb or something like that. He was butt cheeks. And then he fought Tyrone Woodley 2 times. And the first thing, they was like, oh, Tyrone Woodley wasn't ready for the first fight. And then they say he took this fight last minute. So if you know you got beat up the first fight and you wasn't ready, why would you take the second fight? I don't know. I just feel like it's a money thing, because if you go back and look at Tyrone Woodley's career, he's been in the UFC since, I think, like maybe 2012, 2013. He probably accumulated maybe $4 to $5 million his whole 8 years or whatever or so being inside the UFC, right? And then you got old Jake here. This bout, I think they got paid around $2 million each. They split $2 million. And I think there was an extra knockout of $500 grand, whoever knocked out whoever the other person was. Or you get what I'm saying? You're telling me he was able to make about half of what he made in the UFC in one night? Not including his other fight. I don't know how much they made up the other fight, but he's pretty close to meeting his halfway of salary-wise of his whole time being in UFC. And I just find it like hard to believe that a former UFC welterweight champion, bro, gets knocked out by a YouTuber. Now, mind you, Tyrone Woodley is almost about 40 years old, or he is 40 years old, I'm not too sure. He's lost the last fights that he's had in the UFC. I think he lost like about 4 or 5 UFC fights before he started going into this right here. But this is money, people. Like, my thing is, I feel like he got knocked out for the money. Like, I would get knocked out for money. I feel like the knockout was real, but I also feel like he let him knock him out, bro. I feel like he's still fighting people that are not boxers, because right now I still see Tyrone Woodley. Yes, he's a mixed martial artist, but that's what I say. He's a mixed martial artist. He's not able to throw kicks. He's not able to throw knees. He's not able to wrestle. He's not able to grapple. So you're pretty much setting a handicap on the people that you're fighting. Why aren't you fighting real boxers? Like George Masvidal said, he said, if you wanted to fight, then come to the UFC. We'll see what happens. I don't know too much about that. You have to Google it yourself. But he made a video saying, hey, if you want to get knocked out in front of the whole world, come to the UFC. Now, if he goes and knocks out George Masvidal, I'll be quiet, because now you're in their domain and we want to show you over here. Stop bringing people over to your fight and you pick your fight. Start, like, he's not fighting no Tyson Furies. He's not fighting no Gervonta Davises, no Ryan Garcias. He's not fighting those kind of people. Even though they're not in his weight class, I'm just saying he's not fighting boxers. So everybody's like, oh, and for ordering him, you have to understand, after this, Tyrone Woodley is not about to have a fighting career no more. So this is his reason for him to go out with a bang. He's about to get paid off, because damn, Dana White not about to take him serious no more. UFC fighters are not about to take him serious no more. You got knocked out by a YouTuber. Now, I'm not saying that Jake Paul don't go and he trains and stuff like that, but this is, no, I just refuse to believe. Kudos for him for winning the fight. I just don't see him going out the way that he did without some outcome. And I think he gave him the $500,000 that he was rewarded for knocking him out, which is kind of like the, okay, you let me knock you out, here's the extra $500,000 on top of your $2 million that you earned for that fight. You get what I'm saying? And then the little theories and stuff and whatnot. But who knows? Obviously, I think the knockout was real, but I also believe that he let him knock him out for the money.
Doesn't mean he has the technique to do it against anybody, but he has the potential in his power alone. But the real question about this was, why did Woodley drop his lead hand? He dropped it as if he was trying to parry Jake Paul's right hand. And the only two possible things that he could have parried here were a right straight coming to his head or a body shot. But in boxing, you're not taught to parry a punch coming to the body like this.
MMA.
Use your elbows and rotate to glance the punch off of your elbows. And the crazy thing about it was, Jake telegraphed the overhand. He winded it up, gave a huge tell that he was going to throw it. I mean, he loaded up on his right shoulder. He rotated his stance perpendicular to Woodley, dropped his right hand, which gives the indication that he's going to swing it over with that momentum. And the punch itself wasn't necessarily fast. And Jake didn't necessarily make it look like he was going to throw right straight at all. Tyron Woodley made a huge error trying to parry an obvious right overhand. And because of that, it's also an aspect as to why he got knocked out so badly. He did not know what punch was coming. He thought it was going to be right straight. He thought he can parry it. It became a right overhand. He didn't see him and it blindsided him. And the funny thing about this was, Jake has thrown this combination in the fight prior. He faked with a jab to the body, but came up with a right straight instead. Which means, I don't think it was a body shot that Tyron thought was coming at him. Number one, you don't defend body shots like that. And number two, Jake went with a right straight before. So there could have been a conditioning factor to this. Jake throwing this fake jab to a right straight may have conditioned Tyron to parry instead of block like he did before, but the telegraph on the overhand was so massive, Tyron still should have been able to see that. Credit to Tyron Woodley for taking the fight on 2 weeks' notice. Of course, he's gonna get paid heavily for the fight, but there's always a level of danger when you go into the ring, just like tonight showed. And
the level of danger going into the ring with Jake Paul. Yo, respect. But a lot of people say he was setting it up the whole fight. He was setting it up. But my thing is, even if Tyron Woodley is not a boxer, bro, like, you fight to standing up. You block plenty of shots from people that hit way heavier than Jake Paul, bro. Way heavier. You get what I'm saying? But if all said and done, if it was a legit punch and he knocked him out, then kudos to him. But I refuse to believe it. That's just like, I just refuse to believe that you can beat somebody that's been training for 8+ years and you just come in and knock him out. I'll say one thing. The moment he takes on a real boxer and he knocks him out or even lasts the whole 12 rounds, or not somebody that's old, not somebody that's lost the last 5 or 6 of their fights, somebody, you know, somebody that has experience, somebody that has been boxing their whole life, if he fights them, bro, and he survives or even knocks them out, bro, I'll shut up. I'll come back and apologize on YouTube, bro. I just feel like this wasn't real for me. I just feel like it was money.
Jake Paul's show is going to continue. He's probably going to fight Tommy Fury next. He's calling out Nate Diaz and Jorge Masvidal. After this knockout, a lot of people are going to be interested in Jake's next fight. Even though this rematch with Woodley, for the majority of it, was pretty boring. I'm not going to lie. I mean, not much was happening. There were more headbutts than there were punches, and even more clinches to go with that. It ultimately was a very inactive fight, and if for it to end so suddenly like that, I'm not gonna lie, it really woke me up. We did learn one other thing about Jake Paul in this. Being cut in a fight, he's still able to fight it through. The guy is tough. When things aren't going his way, he's not gonna wither under that. He's gonna try to make things work and going to look for that knockout blow. So respect to Jake Paul for that kind of result and his ability to go into the fight like that, face a little bit of adversity, and respect to Tyron Woodley for taking the fight on such short notice and giving respect to Jake after the fight. And it seems like, man, MMA has lost.
Like you say, he took the fight 2 weeks prior or anything like that, but he's like, MMA lost. Well, of course MMA is going to lose, because MMA was not utilized in the boxing ring. Like, I'm pretty sure if he would have went over to, you know, the UFC, would have been a different story. But yes, if you're, that's just like me taking somebody that's a right hand dominant puncher and I tell them to tie your hand behind your back. You can't utilize that hand for the whole fight. Yeah, you can't utilize jiu-jitsu, Brazilian jiu-jitsu, kickboxing, Muay Thai. You can't utilize anything but your hands, or you're used to, you know what I'm saying, blocking kicks and knees and shit. Like, you used to just Street Fighter type fighting. And you, I don't know, but let me know down in the comment section what you guys think. This video is by the Weasel, so if you guys haven't already, shoot the script box. Call the link, watch it in its entirety, because I was pausing to stop and talking through the whole thing. But yeah, like I said, this is all based off of my opinion. No hate towards any of the fighters. Let me know down in the comment section what you guys think. And yeah.